One of the key challenges when it comes to rolling out 5G or indeed any new generation of mobile technology are the costs involved in deploying a new radio access network. Now, one of the ways that these costs can be mitigated is via shared radio access networks. So many mobile operators will have sharing agreements with each other that might involve sharing cell sites, it might involve sharing some of the equipment, it may even involve the pooling or sharing of radio frequencies. Now, neutral host networks are a similar solution, but this coverage, the radio access network itself or parts of the RAN, are provided and maintained by a third party. Now, as part of this agreement, the third party will potentially lease or provide access to different mobile service providers for a fee. Now, the benefit here is that mobile service providers can focus on their core deployments, which with 5G, this is still challenging as there are very few standalone networks which fully utilize a 5G core. So we can see then in a shared network or in a neutral host network scenario, we may have multiple different operators connecting via a single unified radio access network architecture. Now, this could be on a national basis, this could be on a regional basis, it can even go down to as granular a level as individual locations. So it may be, for example, that venues such as sports stadiums or concert venues provide some form of small cell radio access network that extends connectivity. So this may be in terms of capacity. So in venues such as sports stadiums where they're only really at peak capacity, maybe once or twice a week, and this places additional demands on the mobile network. Well, in these cases, a single neutral host on a single site is able to provide extended coverage. And the benefit here to service providers is that they don't need to invest heavily in infrastructure that isn't going to reach peak demands more than one or two times a week. So there are a number of cost benefits to service providers of utilizing a neutral host network. Now, in terms of network sharing options, so this would apply in a neutral host scenario where the radio access network is provided and managed by a third party, but also in network sharing scenarios between operators. So we have passive sharing, which, as we can see, involves any of the non-electrical components. So this could be the cell site itself. It could be things such as the mast or the ducting that's used, but none of the powered components are shared between operators. Now, this has some benefits, particularly in terms of cell site cost and acquisition. So it doesn't really make sense for multiple operators to be competing over different cell sites to deploy radio access equipment. It makes sense that where possible, this is pooled. And of course, this has benefits beyond the service providers since it reduces visual clutter and the amount of radio infrastructure that needs to be deployed. Next, we have active sharing. So this includes sharing of all of the same components used in passive sharing. But in addition to this, this would also include things such as radio equipment, base stations, and things such as backhaul, for example. Now, one of the ways that we can deploy this neutral host network infrastructure is using something known as MOCN. This is multi-operator core network. And this is a method standardized by the 3GPP. Now, there are additional ways that we can, additional architectures that we can use to deploy shared networks and neutral host networks. So we've got things such as gateway core network and also MORAN, multiple operator radio access network. And they all share the same common principle, and that is they allow the sharing of radio infrastructure. So in this MOCN example, then we have our base station, which will broadcast a number of different PLMN identities, public land mobile network identities. In other words, it will broadcast the identities of several different mobile service providers, all of whom are sharing the same radio infrastructure, but have their own distinct core networks. So a subscriber is able to select the appropriate PLMN ID, and they will then be connected to the corresponding core network for that mobile service provider. So the benefits here are clear. This allows for cost reduction when it comes to rolling out a new radio access network. It also allows costs to be shared. So in the case of single neutral hosts, perhaps site owners that are deploying additional cellular connectivity or small cell deployments, so this could be sports stadiums, as I mentioned earlier, this could be things such as shopping centres. This really reduces the burden on mobile service providers. It's also a common sense approach in terms of energy efficiency, in terms of reducing clutter, for example, in urban environments. So we must bear in mind that certainly for 5G and for future generations, we can expect to see a much greater use of higher frequencies, which don't propagate as far and thus would require, you know, quite a dense network. So this is this idea of cell densification, where we would need a greater density of cells, and we will see a multitude of different small cell deployments, for example. So if we take the example of a city environment, an urban metropolitan environment, where we might see small cells deployed as part of street furniture, so street lamps and signs and things such as that. Now, it doesn't make sense, once again, for each operator to deploy their own equipment. It's costly for the operators to do that, but it also creates visual clutter. And so there are a number of benefits to sharing this radio infrastructure or outsourcing this infrastructure to a third party, to a neutral host network.